So my name is Michelle Alexander. I am a lecturer here at the University of York. I am a specialist in stable isotope analysis to understand the diet of people in the past. When you're looking at isotopes that we use in terms of diet, they're stable. So when you eat something, the signature of that food in terms of its isotopes is retained and stays the same once it reaches your body tissues. You are continuously renewing your bone. So when you eat something, that signature will stay for as long as it takes that bone to completely be replaced. And that usually takes about 10 or so years. Teeth, on the other hand, are a little bit different. They form in sort of layers, if you like, all the way down to the bottom of the root. So if I look at this tooth root, what it will tell me is what someone's diet was like between the time that that tooth was forming. If we're looking at a first molar, that might be between sort of 0 years and sort of 10 years of life. What we're interested in is looking at the protein within bones. To do that, we need to dissolve away the hard part of the bone, so the mineral, and then we filter the protein to make sure that we get just the protein. We weigh it out into tiny tin capsules, and we burn it in a mass spectrometer. The burning it just releases it as a gas to measure the isotope ratios. We look at carbon and we look at nitrogen. If you're plotting down here on the graph with a kind of low carbon and low nitrogen, then you're probably eating plant-based diet with some probably animal foods in there. High carbon, high nitrogen puts you over here where you're looking at seafood. If you are eating a bit of seafood and a bit of kind of land animal protein, you'd plot right in the middle. So what we wanted to understand was there a change in diet between childhood, and remember that comes from the tooth, and adulthood, which comes from the bone. All of the triangles plot quite close to their partner crosses. So what we're seeing is diet between childhood and adulthood at these sites in this Brighton area didn't change that much. And one of the things we think is going on in the Roman period is you might be seeing these higher nitrogen values associated with people of higher status, so higher class. And then people with low nitrogen values, these are people who can't afford to have a lot of animal protein. So when we look at this Brighton individual, we can see that they plot not among the people with the least amount of kind of protein in their diet, relatively lowish status, but still with animal protein in their diet. And so by looking at the diet and seeing what people were eating in the past, it can tell us something about society. When you compare them to other people, we can understand that person's place in society and something about the culture of that society as well.